Operation IceBridge has arrived at Thule Air Base to kick off this year's survey of Arctic sea ice and the ice sheets and glaciers of Greenland. But just a week ago, they were still at Wallops Flight Facility outfitting a brand new aircraft for the trip. Actually, the NASA C-130 four-engine turboprop cargo plane has seen 5 decades of service, but it's a new aircraft to IceBridge. With its distinctive nose, elevated cockpit, an open cabin, it's a change of pace for the team. But functionally, it's built to do the job.
So the C-130, it's an interesting aircraft. Again, this one for us is a new airplane. It's about my age, actually, but Wallops just got it about a year ago. First time we've installed in it. It has some advantages, some disadvantages over the P-3 that we normally take to Greenland. Pretty similar performance, really. Roughly similar range, roughly similar ground speed, maneuverability characteristics, that sort of thing.
For the past few months, the Wallops and IceBridge teams have been busy making sure the aircraft is properly configured for the mission's many laser, radar, and photographic instruments.
That was a long road. It's always a big deal putting all these instruments. There's a whole suite of them on board what to us is a new airplane. A lot of design work, a lot of machining, a lot of cutting of metal, a lot of redesigning and remachine work and recutting of metal when the first one doesn't always work out like we hope. Once we're modularized and designed into the system, it'll be pretty easy, but the first time is hard, and that's what's been an issue with this particular deployment, because all of our optical instruments have to be machined to fit to look out of a particular viewport in the bottom. All the wiring has to work. The equipment you see behind you here, which is precise navigation equipment, which helps us put the airplane directly underneath the satellite path or directly over one of our previous paths from IceBridge. All that has to be wired into the system, tested, flight tested, and that's what we're in the process of doing now.
1 week later, with all test flights a success, IceBridge is now 6,000 miles to the north, already has its first flight in the books, and will be flying out of Greenland and Fairbanks, Alaska for the next 2 months.